The most important part of your LifeShield home security system is you, because you're the one who controls it. Here you'll learn how to use your home security system. Using your LifeShield touchpad or your entry keypad is easiest when you're at home. Using the keychain remote is easiest when you're arriving at home, and using the LifeShield mobile app or website is easiest when you're away from home and have forgotten to arm your system. However you choose to control your system, you'll need to select one of three arming modes: stay, away, or instant. Choose stay when you or someone else is at home. Your door and window sensors will be armed, but will only trigger the alarm after the preset delay you've set for entering and exiting your home. In this mode, your motion sensors will remain off, so you can move freely inside your home. Choose away when no one is home. Your door and window sensors will be armed with the same entry and exit delay, but now your motion sensors will be active, providing an added layer of protection. Choose instant when everyone's home for the night and there won't be further exit or entry. Your motion sensors are off, but now door and window sensors are set to trigger an alarm instantly. Once you use your system a few times, these three modes will become second nature. And remember, with LifeShield, you can protect your home from anywhere using your smartphone, tablet, or computer. If your alarm goes off, what happens next? Here we'll walk you through LifeShield's protocol for handling those crucial seconds when your alarm is triggered. Once the alarm sounds, you have 30 seconds to disable it before the LifeShield Monitoring Center is notified. If the alarm was triggered by accident, you can silence it by entering your master code into your LifeShield touchpad, entry keypad, or mobile app. If you don't silence it after 30 seconds, the monitoring center is notified and immediately calls the first contact on your list. If the first contact answers and provides the agent with your secret monitoring passcode, the alarm is canceled. If the first contact cannot provide the proper password, the agent will immediately dispatch the authorities to your home to make sure you are safe. If the first contact does not answer, the monitoring center will call the second contact. If the second contact does not answer or cannot provide the agent with the monitoring passcode, the agent will dispatch the authorities. However, there is an exception to this protocol, the panic button. When you activate the panic button, the LifeShield Monitoring Center automatically dispatches the authorities without calling your contacts. To help prevent false alarms and comply with local laws, panic can only be activated when you are home, on the touchpad. Touch the panic button and then select your emergency. On the entry keypad, you must simultaneously hold the star and pound buttons. And on the keychain remote, you must press the stay and star buttons at the same time. To learn more about how to handle alarms and emergencies, explore the knowledge base on your LifeShield touchpad or visit lifeshield.com/support-center.